Welcome, researcher. Please insert your keycard to access the chosen file. Thank you. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
Object hash, SCP-927 Objects Class, Euclid Special Containment Procedures. The neighborhood containing SCP-927 is to be quarantined. No civilians are to be permitted entry. SCP-927 is to be staffed by 10 biological containment personnel at all times. Flamethrowers are to be kept on location at all times and are to be used in the event of nearby properties becoming infested. Any civilians inquiring about SCP-927's level of security are to be informed that the area has been quarantined as a result of a radiation leak. In the event of extended inquiry on the part of civilians, concerned individuals are to be brought into custody and dosed with a class A amnestic. Description: SCP-927 is a dilapidated three-story residence in the small town of .22. Slightly decomposed corpses are present inside SCP-927, one male and one female. The male corpse shows signs of blunt trauma to the head and neck, and severe lacerations are present on the right leg. The female corpse shows signs of strangulation and blunt trauma to the ribs. Present on a table within SCP-927's kitchen is a glass of carbonated soda, since gone flat. A fruit bowl on the same table contains a slightly rotted apple. The leg in the northeast corner of the table has snapped and been replaced with an iron pole, crudely attached to the table using nails. On the wall of the dining room of SCP-927 is a slightly torn portrait of a sunflower. The stairs leading to the second floor of SCP-927 are slightly damaged and the third step has completely collapsed. Signs of termite infestation are evident inside SCP-927. The source of SCP-927's anomalous properties are an unidentified form of microorganism, hereafter referred to as SCP-927-1. SCP-927-1 has infested all surfaces inside SCP-927, and is also present within all liquids in the residence. Since the SCP-927-1 infestation, SCP-927 has shown no further structural collapse and all biological tissue within SCP-927 has ceased decomposing. SCP-927-1 reproduces quickly and has on multiple occasions infested other properties in the area. Upon infestation of a residence, SCP-927-1 will proceed to replicate SCP-927's conditions. SCP-927-1 will infest any humans in the residence, usually killing them by tunneling through their heart. SCP-927-1 will then proceed to systematically injure the corpse. In the case of males, SCP-927-1 will replicate blunt trauma to the head and neck, and will tunnel through the right leg to create severe lacerations. In the case of females, SCP-927-1 will apply precise trauma to simulate strangulation and blunt trauma to the ribs. If there are more humans residing in the infested residence than SCP-927, any additional corpses within the infested residence will be broken down extremely quickly, until no evidence of its existence remains. SCP-927-1 within victims' bodies will, through a process as of yet unknown, alter its DNA until it is identical to the corresponding body within SCP-927. Any carbonated liquids within SCP-927 will go flat and fruit will rot to a certain point, and then cease decomposition completely. SCP-927-1 will convert the leg in the northeast corner of any table within an infested residence to iron, and produce nails identical to those in SCP-927. Any paintings, portraits or photographs within the infested residence will be converted to a slightly torn painting of a sunflower. If residence is infested by SCP-927-1 possess a second floor, the third step will be tunneled through and made to collapse. SCP-927-1 will produce live termites within the walls until the residence can be considered infested. SCP-927-1 will tunnel through surfaces until they have reached a similar state of collapse as SCP-927. Removing objects from SCP-927 appears to have no effect on this conversion process, as it would seem SCP-927-1 is operating on a template of SCP-927's state when it was first infested. SCP-927-1 has proved vulnerable to heat, and use of flamethrowers is advised to deal with infected residences.